In this video, we're going to look at how to tell a story with your data from generative design. In this case, we're going to analyze this data in a platform called Power BI for Microsoft. So with generative design, we are now able to export our outcomes to CSV files along with thumbnails. We're going to create a dashboard similar to the one open on the screen now. This is a Power BI dashboard that's built using the data right from generative design. So in our case, we have all of our available options on the left-hand side. And if I go through and start selecting options, the data updates live. So in this case, we're able to preview that specific thumbnail of the option that we have selected, the total number of unique panels within that option versus the total count. And we also have that reiterated about the midpoint of the visualization. We also have an image cloud over to the right that will render based on how many options we have selected. So the more options I pick, the more that preview gets displayed with options. That one's optional. That is an additional visualization, but all of the others are built into Power BI directly. So with that all pointed out, we can go ahead and get our data ready for export to eventually use it in Power BI. Back in Revit, we are in our sample file titled Staggered Curtain Wall. In order to export our data, we need to navigate to the Explore Outcomes window. Once again, this can be found under the Manage tab, the Generative Design panel, and the Explore Outcomes button. With this window open, we will be prompted to select a study that we previously created. In my case, I'm going to go ahead and select the most recent study that relates to the curtain wall example that we covered previously. To recap, we have all of our thumbnails available and all of the data used to create this study with generative design. With generative design, we are now able to export the outcomes. This can be accessed through the ellipses button, which is this three dots next to that current study. So we can select the ellipses button and select Export Outcomes. In our case, we're going to export all generated outcomes and we'll include the thumbnails for visualization. Once we select the Export button, we will be prompted to save these files somewhere. This can be any location that you would like. In my case, I have a OneDrive folder titled Facade Example, so I'll just export it there. When the export is complete, we will get a successfully created notification on our Explore Outcomes window. Next, we'll navigate to the folder to be able to extract these files for use in Power BI. In our folder, we have a zip file. We can go ahead and right-click on this file and extract it. It will give us a folder name that relates to that study's name, so we'll just go ahead and extract them into the default folder. With generative design, we will receive each one of the thumbnails and a CSV file containing all of the data from that study. Let's go ahead and double click on the CSV file to open it in Excel. So by default with generative design, we get a couple of extra rows related to how generative design created this study. In our case for Power BI, we don't need these rows and they'll just cause us trouble. So we'll go ahead and select row 1 and 2, right click and delete them. So within this data, we have an ID, which relates to that result. It's a long, unique ID. We have all of the other data that we used in generative design, and that's pretty much it. In order to make this super clear, I do want to add an additional column. So if we add a column titled Option, we can go ahead and number all these columns really quickly. In Excel, I'm going to go ahead and number the first two rows, select those two numbers that I created, and drag it to the end of Excel. So in my case, I know that I only have double digit options, so I just entered 01 to start with. If you had triple digits, you could do that as well. So there we go. We have an option saved in here now. We'll go ahead and save our file and close it. So by default, Excel does not have any notion of the thumbnails involved with each option. With generative design, we do get all the data exported to us, but we need to relate this data back to the image somehow. We also need to store the images somewhere public for Power BI to access. So in the case of where to store our files for generative design, they simply need to be at a URL that's publicly accessible without logging in. In my case, I use GitHub for creating Dynamo packages and managing code. It's free to sign up. It's owned by Microsoft, and you are able to host files on it. Dynamo is actually hosted on GitHub and is open source, so it's a good platform to get involved with sooner than later. So you would simply sign up, and then we'll look at how to upload these into what is called a repository. So once you have a GitHub account, you will go through and click on New Repository. This can be accessed in this plus sign on the upper right corner of GitHub. You would click on New Repository. In this case, these are simply images or thumbnails for my curtain wall example. So I'm going to title this Generative Design Curtain Wall Thumbnails. The description is optional, but you can add a more specific description if you would like. We're going to make this public so that way you can see it. In addition to GitHub, you can host these images on any platform that gives you access to a public URL. GitHub's just really simple and it's a drag and drop interface. In order to enable this to actually have a drag and drop interface, we're going to go ahead and let it add a README file. This describes what your repository is doing. It's just a boilerplate to get started, and it enables us to drag and drop files right into the interface. So let's go ahead and click on Create Repository. Once we have our GitHub repo created, we do see something that looks similar to this. It has a default README with just the boilerplate text of the repository name and nothing else. What we're going to do is I'll tile my windows. We're going to go ahead and select all the thumbnails, so we won't select the CSV, and we'll just drag these right into the GitHub window on our browser window. GitHub will go through and load the image files. In my case, I have 40. We'll let that finish. Once that is complete, we can scroll to the bottom. It automatically gives us a commit message, which is illustrating what we're doing, and we can click on commit changes. Once GitHub uploads all of the files, we can go ahead and navigate back to the homepage, and we'll see that we have all of our thumbnails available to us. You can also create a folder for these. In this example, we're just uploading them to have an access point for them. So we'll go ahead and select an image to preview it, and we'll see that we have our thumbnail. In the case of making this work with our Excel file for Power BI, we do need to get this URL to be able to link it inside of the Excel file. The easiest way to do this would be to right-click on the download button and click on Copy Link Address. This gives us the publicly accessible address for this image. Included in the dataset for this lesson is a Dynamo graph that allows us to map that URL within our Excel file for images. So what we'll go ahead and do is open up Dynamo. You can open Dynamo in Revit or Dynamo Sandbox, and we'll open the attached file to this lesson titled Create Thumbnails. Within Create Thumbnails, all it's simply doing is reading our directory, and it's adding a prefix of that URL for us within the Excel file. Then it's exporting it as a new Excel file called Data with Thumbnails, just to differentiate it. This file is annotated and it has all of the directions in it to describe what we're doing. So that GitHub URL that we copied, that's going to go into this Your GitHub URL portion of the graph. In my case, I did copy the PNG file at the end, so it's this big unique ID.png. We just need to remove that portion from the string entry. In the case of our directory of images, that would be the folder that you extracted the zip file into. Mine's right here, so I'll just copy that address as well and paste that into my directory of images input. Next, we need to find our CSV file. In my case, that is in that same folder that I extracted. It is titled Staggered Curtain Wall 001.csv. So once we point to that file, we can go ahead and select Run. Our Dynamo graph will run, and you will notice Excel open in the background. As it was before, we do have our ID and our option that we added, but we also have thumbnails available to us now. As you can see, I have github.com, my username, the project name, and then the link to the PNG file that relates. So this file already saved because we exported it from Dynamo, so we can go ahead and leave that alone now. You can also close Dynamo. You can save changes if you'd like. So now within our exported folder, we have an option for data with thumbnails.xlsx. This is the file that we're going to connect to Power BI. So in the case of this example, we are visualizing this data with Power BI, which is once again a platform from Microsoft. I am using the desktop version, so you can navigate to Power BI desktop version and download that and get that all set up. In Power BI, this is what your home screen will look like. So by default, we have an untitled project for Power BI desktop. In our case, we want to import data from Excel, so we'll go ahead and select this option. In our folder, we have our data with thumbnails.xlsx, the one that we just created from Dynamo with all of our thumbnails available. Let's go ahead and select that file and click open. Power BI will ask you where do you want to load data from. In our case, the file has a sheet named data, and you can preview all the data available to us here. For this data, it is all good to go. We cleaned it up already in Excel, and we can go ahead and click on load. So by default, Power BI does not include any visualizations. In the dataset for this example, we do have the .pbix file from Power BI available to you if you just want to open that up. We are going to create this from scratch though. So what we'll go ahead and do is we'll go ahead and add this slicer object in our visualizations panel. So by clicking on slicer, it becomes an option available to us. By default, it doesn't have any data being used, so we do need to add some data. That's accessible in the right side of Power BI under the fields option. For this visualization, I know that I want to see the option number. So option, there are all of our available options. You are able to add the thumbnails as well if you want. By default, the thumbnail is going to show the URL, so we'll fix that next. This allows selectable options at this point. So as you can see, the URL for the images is what's showing by default. That's not exactly what we want, so we need to change that. In Power BI, we are able to look at the data in the left-hand corner of the screen. So if we select data, we'll have all of our data available to us. In the case of our thumbnails, if we select this column, it is showing that it's uncategorized as data at this point. If we select this dropdown, we're able to change this to an image URL. By making that change, when we navigate back to our visualization, we are able to toggle to be able to see the thumbnails. So if I were to remove the option here, we will see thumbnails available to us. In this case, we're going to use a different visualization for the thumbnails, so let's go ahead and drop that from this one. This is simply a selector available to us. To visualize thumbnails, we are able to use a table view. So we'll go ahead and pick this visualization and place it on the screen now. Once again, there's no data assigned to this visual. So let's go ahead and drag our option and our thumbnail. So what this does is it allows us to preview what option we're selecting along with our thumbnail. The great thing with Power BI is each one of these visuals are related to one another. So if I go through and start selecting options, it will start to summarize these a bit. In the case of our visual right here, we are seeing just one option at a time. By default, our current visualizations are allowing us to see one option at a time. In order to change this, we'll select our slicer, which is this left visualization, and we will navigate to format category. Multi-select with control is the default method. I prefer the checkbox, so we'll go ahead and let that be an option for everyone. You can check all of the options that you want to visualize in this right panel. But you are able to customize these quite a bit under the format options. You can add titles and other display options. For now, we'll leave these as is. Let's go ahead and place another type of visualization. For this one, we'll use a stacked bar chart. You are able to drag these around the screen. So for stacked bar chart, we will have this option. We need to add some values to this. I want to look at unique panel types, so I'll drag that to the values, and total number. In addition to that data, we want to group these by the option that they relate to. So we can see if we hover, option 4 has 7 unique panels and a total of 120 panels. This is a really quick way to summarize data for any given option. Inside of the slicer, which is on the left-hand portion of the screen, we can clear all selections and visualize everything. So there's our total visualization, and we can see each option as it's related. With these visualizations added, we can go ahead and add some titles. So let's go ahead and drag this down. We go to format, you can turn on the title. We will title this select options, and that will tell the end user what to do with this option. And then this would be the thumbnail preview. So we can go ahead and title that. And this one already has a title that's pretty good. So we'll just make it a little bit bigger to make it clearer. In addition to visuals, we can go ahead and add titles and other options within Power BI. So we'll go ahead and add a text box, and we'll say curtain wall panel optioneering. We're going to make this a larger font and a little bit bolder as well. I like to use Arial Black for these titles because that's really bold. And that will be our title. And then you are also able to modify the appearance. There is a dark mode, which is really nice. So we can have that enabled, and we have all of our visualization going. In addition to selecting our options on the slicer object, we can go through and select thumbnails, and it will isolate that option's data down across the other visuals. This is really cool because as you add more visuals to your preview, you can start to filter them down throughout all of the visualizations. Really fun stuff. In addition to the thumbnail that's included, we are able to format the image to be larger. So by default, it's a height of 75. If we click on format and go to grid, we can change the image height to make it a little bit bigger. So this is great because as we go through, we can drill down and get that data filtered out. There are tons of visuals that you can start to explore in Power BI. This is more of a getting started with the data from generative design. I encourage you to check out some of the other options available to you. Add more, you can add other pages, you can ask questions of the data and more. We will explore how to build upon this in a future video, but there it is, how to get started telling your story based on your generative design data within Power BI.